In this demo, we are using ESP8266 Wi-Fi microcontroller module. This module has connected with the DS18b20 temperature sensor, which is based on OneWire protocol. So in this demo, we read the temperature from the temperature sensor and upload to the IoT cloud. We'll also show how to create a dashboard to view this temperature uploaded from the microcontroller module. Let us go to the demo. Go to arduino.cc and click on the cloud menu. This will open a new cloud page. In the cloud page, click on the get started. Now we can see three different cloud applications supported by Arduino Cloud. So one is IoT Cloud, Web Builder, and a Manager for Linux. IoT Cloud is used for adding the devices and creating dashboards. Web Builder is an online web-based IDE where we can develop a program. And Manager for Linux is the application for Linux boards like Raspberry Pi and all. So let's go to IoT Cloud. On IoT Cloud page, we can add devices, dashboards, and things to our account. So let us add the device. In this demo, we are using ESP8266, which is a third-party device. Select the third-party device, and the model of the device is Wemos D1 Mini. Select that Wemos D1 Mini model. Give the device name as a temperature node, that is temp node. Now Arduino Cloud will generate two keys. One is a device ID, another one is a secret key. These two values we have to save in the notepad for using in the future. So then click continue once these two values are saved in the notepad. Now we have successfully created a device in our account. Once the devices are created, we can create a thing or multiple things to each device. The thing is a variable which we will be uploading to the cloud or which can be controlled from the cloud in the device. So let us create a temperature variable for our device, which is the thing which we will be sending to the cloud. The name of the variable or the thing we are using is a temperature, and its a data type is a basic float type of data type, because the temperature value we will be sending is a float variable. So we select the basic data type as a float variable. And this is a read-only variable, and this variable is updated at every 2 seconds. So this is how we are selecting in the cloud. Now we have created a device and corresponding things for the device. Let us go to the web editor where the sketch is automatically generated, and we need to add our customized code for this sensor and all using web editor. So let us go to the full web editor and start editing the code. The sketch automatically generated supports ESP8266 board. Now we need to add libraries corresponding to our temperature sensor, that is Dallas temperature and OneWire protocol. So we add these two libraries to our sketch and also add the corresponding code for reading the temperature sensor and printing it on the serial console. Create the instance of OneWire class and pass D1 pin as an argument. So this is the pin to which the sensor is connected. Pass the reference of this object to Dallas temperature class and do the required initialization using the begin method. We can read the temperature from the sensor using appropriate calls like request temperature and get temperature calls, and assign the temperature value read from the sensor to the float variable, which is the corresponding variable for the thing which we created when we create a device. Let us print the temperature value in the serial console using serial print method. Now let us go and click on the build icon. So the error we are seeing is because we have not selected the appropriate board. So let us select the board which we have created. Next, we have to give the device secret key which we have saved and Wi-Fi credentials in the secret tab. Now the build is successful and we can download the image to the target board. Once the image is downloaded, it starts executing and we can see the console prints in the left side of the editor in the console. Let us go to the IoT cloud to create a dashboard and view the value of the things updated. Click on the dashboard and select build dashboard. In the different widgets available, I am selecting a gauge widget to display the temperature and select the thing which we wanted to display, that is the temperature, and click OK. Now we can observe that this dashboard and the gauge displays the temperature that is being transmitted by the ESP node at every 2 seconds interval. So we can see the temperature value keep updating based on the value that is sent by the node.